Mr. Robinson, tell me about this building. It used to be a bathhouse until 1971, and you turned it into the most successful gym. How did you do it?
We done it. We dedicated ourselves to the area. The club's been going many, many years. Twice us walking in here. In the old days, in this part of town, people didn't have baths, they didn't have showers. You'd come down here, have a little area there, we've done your bath. When that all went, people become bitter, rich around here, they had more around showers and baths. So we took this building over, got all the local kids in here, and we've established the number one club in the country. What we are, the number one club in the country.
What are you going to do when you run out of real estate with so many champions on the wall?
We go higher.
You go higher?
We go higher and higher.
Yeah. Look, there's no
there's
room.
To see you in London. We go higher and higher.
But if anybody in London wants to train here, what does it take? If I'm a kid in London, 8 to 30.
Yeah, you come down here, you see us. All we say to you is we give you a 4-week trial. Within them duration of 4 weeks, we expect you in there sparring. The moment we see you sparring, we know if you want it or not. If you don't want to spar, you don't want to box, piss off. Simple as that, they told. Where they go.
Thank you.
I fully understand, man.
Yeah?
You see how skillful them kids are, like, isn't it? See how skillful
13, 14 years old. And this fight's more, this sparring is more entertaining than some of the fights.
Yeah, yeah, see, so you see that's the only pool they go for. Yeah.
Ooh. That was a haymaker.
They back you up. They back you up. They're hungry. Kelvin, they ain't gonna come down.